y'all, what's going on? Popping in here real quick to do another. Yeah, I have the light on the side. I didn't put the light on the camera, so we're gonna just make it do what it do. I'm here to do another random question video. Random question, yeah. Remember, if you like these videos, put it down below in the comments. Thumbs it up and I'll do them. Alrighty. If you had one extra hour of free time a day, how would you use it? I think there's enough time in the day. I don't know. How would I use it? Will probably be like more than that. You know, it's time to go to sleep. Another extra hour of sleep. Put it like that. What CD is in your CD player right now? What's a CD player? Nah, I'm joking. I don't have any CD players anymore. The last one I bought was for my folks because they, you know, give them CDs, they play their CDs. They don't know about iPod and all that. They know about it, but to teach, CDs. But I ain't got no CD. I think I done gave away or threw away on my CD. What, they still sell those? The great theologian Andy Warhol stated that everyone gets 15 minutes of fame. What happened during your 15 minutes? That's a cool question. I didn't know I had one. No, let me stop. My 15 minutes of fame, again, was when I had my magazines, when I was going to interview Kirk Franklin. And somebody I knew from a while ago in college, you know, when they saw me there, like, what you doing here? Like, if I didn't have a right to be there, bitch, you there too, shit. Anyway, it's funny, Kirk came in, and who did he walk over to? How you doing? Because every issue of my magazine that I did, I sent it to his people, to his camp. Every issue that came out, I sent it over there. So they he was familiar with my face because my face was on every issue. So he came over to me and he was like, don't I know you? I'm like, no. He's like, don't you have it? So that was my 15 minutes of fame and it was awesome. Be humble, bitches. I'm just saying. Name the most famous person you've had a face-to-face encounter with. I guess it's been... See, I mean, everybody's... I hate this famous shit. I would say... What is this? Face-to-face encounter? Brush... It's a lot of gospel artists. And I would, again, say it's Kirk Franklin. You got Hezekiah. But all y'all probably don't know who the heck I'm talking about unless y'all, used to be in the gospel circuit or you still are. Whatever. Name your favorite children's story. Because growing up, I was thinking again, my parents didn't read no Three Little Pigs and Cinderella stories. You read that in school? I would say Goldilocks and the Three Bears. Yeah, I would say that one. Yeah. If you could spend 50 minutes with any living person, who would it be? What? If any living person? Doing what? Next. What person in the Bible do you most closely identify with? Job. I'm just saying. Next. What article of clothing most closely describes your personality? Article of clothing. I would say a coat. A coat or a jacket, yeah. If you were to write a book, what would it be about? What would it be about? Damn, it could be on a whole lot of things. But I think if I was to write a book, it would just be about my life experiences and what I've learned and stuff. I think that's what, yeah. Honey, ooh, child. How many rings before you answer the phone? Well, depending on who it is. Or you just go right to voicemail. Yeah. But usually it's two. Yeah, two rings. What is the first thing you think of when you wake up in the morning? I'm thankful to see another day. I thank God that my eyes can open. I may have aches and pains, but thank God I can feel them. If you won $1 million, what would you do with it? I would just be living very comfortably. I wouldn't be all flashy, you know, let me get 3 cars and 6 houses and all this. No, I would just be living very comfortable. If you had to, what part of the body would you get pierced? my ears again. I miss wearing earrings, you know, this whole keloid shit, fierce. But I miss wearing earrings. And like, there's space on my ears that I could pierce, but I'm afraid that I'm gonna get more keloids. So I just say, you know what? Cut my losses, leave my ears alone. Who was your favorite teacher and why? I would say my favorite teacher was my math teacher, who was also, this is in college, who was also the head of the computer labs. And the reason why is because he is the reason why I got interested into computers. And that was my first computer job working when I was in college, so he was my favorite. Because I used to have, I mean, everyone knows I asked a lot of questions, and I used to ask him, you know, this Max was like the Max looked like a box. Oh my God. Max were like, come on, Sandy, do you? It was like a box, the Max. They were so, they used to take them, flop them. And I used to ask so many questions. How do you do this? How do you do that? Da, 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 da. To one day, he said, go learn it yourself. And I sat and I went through them and I learned. And I was hired to work there, to run one of the shifts in the lab. So, yeah, he started, yes, where I am today, my love of computer. You know, he started me interested in desktop publishing. All this, yeah, that was my favorite teacher. Da, 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 da. Where am I? What makes you feel the most secure? Being loved for the right reasons. Who do you admire the most? I can't say anyone in particular. I just admire strong people, specifically strong women. Not physical strength, but emotionally strong. And we some strong bitches. No, we're not bitches, sorry. We're strong. And I just really admire strong women who, no excuses, they just do. That's who I admire most. Have you had a recurring dream? Yeah, but I'm not gonna say that. My recurring dream, And I've looked it up, and you know, I've seen what it means, and yeah. What was your nickname growing up or now? I didn't really have a nickname. Sam. My brother used to call me Bubbler. But it's just Sam, because my name's Samantha, so Sam. Yeah. Who was your hero when you were a child, and what did you do to be like them? I didn't really have a hero. Oh, I like Superman, Wonder Woman. I didn't really have a hero like that. My heroes were and are my parents, because you know, I wasn't, people like this, you know, I wasn't, through them I've seen what it is to work hard and get what you want in life, and to know that nothing comes easy, but if you want it, you can have it. So those are my heroes. That's what I see heroes as. Superman, Batman, they could kiss my ass, shits, whatever. Last question, peanut or plain? I would say peanut, because I'm taking this, I'm just using, they talking about M&M's. Nah, I say peanut because I love anything with peanuts in it. I said peanuts or peanut, oh shit. Anything with peanuts in it. Yeah, I like peanut M&M's, Snickers, oh my Jesus. Yeah, plain is just peanut. Anyway, y'all, hope y'all enjoyed this segment, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace, y'all.